Good evening. Tonight we're going to make a maple sweet potato shepherd's pie. Usually with shepherd's pie, I'll usually make it with beef or pork. Tonight I'm going to use a ground chicken. In my pot on the stove, I have three sweet potatoes that I peeled and chopped, and I'm bringing them to a boil. You want to bring them to a boil and let them cook for 20 minutes until they're soft. While that's cooking, I have one carrot, one onion. I'm going to put that in our hot pan here with a tablespoon of olive oil. We're going to saute this probably for about 3 to 4 minutes until it gets soft. Okay, as you can see, the onions are starting to render down. I'm going to take my pound of organic chicken breast, and I'm going to break that up into pieces, and we're going to cook it for about 10 minutes so that everything starts to cook down. So about 10 minutes on this, and I'll be back. Okay, in the pan, everything, all the turkey, I mean, sorry, the chicken is cooked through. I'm going to add 3/4 cup of chicken stock. And I'm going to add 1/4 cup of organic heavy cream. And then I'm going to add 1/4 cup of pure maple syrup. And I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of tomato paste. I'm just eyeballing it. I buy my tomato paste in the tube because it lasts a lot longer. Then you can keep it in the fridge for quite a while. And then I'm going to add my fresh rosemary that I just chopped up. So we're going to give this a stir. And then we're going to let this cook down for approximately 10 minutes. So you're going to stir it till everything's incorporated and let it cook down for about 10 minutes. Okay, into this mixture, we're going to put 1 cup of frozen peas. And we're going to let that sit for probably 2 minutes while we're getting our mashed potatoes ready. So just let that sit for a couple minutes while we get our sweet potatoes ready. If you go over to the other area where I've got my sweet potatoes, I put a fork through them to make sure they were cooked. And then I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of butter, 2 ounces of goat cheese, 2 tablespoons of maple syrup. And I'm going to take this, and I have a special tool for mashing these if I don't want to take all the blenders and stuff out. And I'm going to mash these up all together. I'm going to put a little bit of salt in here, probably about 1/2 teaspoon. And then a little bit of fresh ground pepper. All right, so we're going to mash these until they're smooth because you want to get all the goat cheese and butter incorporated. If you don't want to use organic, you don't have to. I choose to eat organic. That's my choice, but you can use whatever is available to you, whatever you can afford. This is a great dish for your family or for company because it's just serve this with a nice salad on the side and you're all set. Take this fork and give it a whip through just to make sure everything's mixed there, because that thing really mashes the potatoes nicely. So I've got my oven preset to 375, which has been preheating since I started cooking. And then we're going to put on top, we're going to shut this off, right on top of the, you can put this in a casserole dish if you want. I choose to put mine right in the oven in my dish. It's one less pot to clean. And then we're gonna just move them, spread them around the top. You can also use, if you want, instead of all sweet potatoes, you can use 2 parsnips and 2 sweet potatoes that you peeled and cooked together. So it's your choice, you can do it either way. I just happened, my store didn't have any parsnips, or I would have done it with parsnips. So we've got that all on top. We're gonna put this into a 375 oven for 35 minutes. Okay, I just pulled this out of the oven. As you can see, it's nice and crispy around the edges. We're gonna give it a nice cut through. I'm gonna try to neatly put this on the plate. Ah, gosh darn it. Well, there you go. I made a mess. It still tastes good. Okay. And there you go. And this is what it looks like if you want to get a nicer picture that I didn't destroy. That's how nice it looks. It makes about 6 servings or so. Have a great week. See you next week. Have a good one.